Western hostages in a U.S. drone strike reignites the debate over drones in general and the rules, such as they are, of targeting Americans. Now, legally, there are two kinds of drone strikes, so-called signature strikes, permitted in Pakistan, where you do not have to identify those you're targeting, and more specific kill list strikes, where each individual target is known, identified, and approved by the president. Time to bring in my lawyers to talk about this. CNN legal analyst Paul Callan and HLN legal analyst Joey Jackson. All right, Joey, so how much due process do U.S. citizens who join up with these terror organizations actually deserve?
Well, deserve is another matter, okay, Randy, because of course we know that they're engaged in terrible acts of, you know, treason against the country. You're talking about acts of terrorism. You're talking about plotting and planning to kill and destroy American lives, and that's a problem. You know, but as Americans, obviously, what happens is that we're a country founded upon due process, founded upon having rights, and founded upon protecting those individual freedoms. Whether they believe the same matters, obviously they don't, which is why they are where they are doing what they do.
Yeah. But Paul, I mean, from a purely legal perspective, in terms of these two different kind of strikes, I mean, how do you justify stricter drone strikes in one country versus the other?
I don't think it's very easy to make that distinction. The Due Process Clause of the Fifth Amendment says you can't deprive an American citizen of his life or liberty without due process of law. And this is what is tearing people apart as they look at this horrible world that we're in now. We're not fighting an identifiable enemy except, you know, sort of these vague terrorist groups. They're trying to kill us. And can we target their leaders? And can we kill one of their leaders if it is an American citizen? You know, we're looking at the Tsarnaev trial up in Boston. Look at the amount of time we spend agonizing about whether he gets put to death or not for his terrorist act. And yet, abroad, if the president says drone strike on an American citizen, can the president order his death? This is a very, very hard question, and it's a new question for the American system of justice.
But sticking with that, are you going to weigh in on that?
No, go ahead.
Okay, sticking with that line of questioning, though, I mean, the officials are saying that neither of these two American Al-Qaeda members were targeted, right?
So does that, it was an accident,
right?
Yes.
Exactly, they weren't specifically targeted. So does that sidestep the whole due process question? Because really, what would stop the U.S. government from saying all the time that this was a mistake, they weren't targeted, this was an accident, right?
I think it certainly changes the dynamic, Randy, in as much as what did they say? It was an accident. It was predicated upon bad intelligence. But we do know, based upon the fact that they were high-level targets, high-level American citizens, that they wouldn't be visible, they wouldn't otherwise be exposed, and the intelligence, you could see where it would be flawed in that regard. But at the end of the day, you know, do people have rights? Absolutely. Do American citizens have rights? Absolutely. But at the same time, you have to look at the nature of the threat that they pose and the horrific consequences of the actions that they engage in, and that's the problem.
Why don't you weigh in on that?
Well, I think historically, when we're looking back in this era, and we have all of the records, and we know what really happened, I think we're going to find out that it was an accidental hit on an American citizen is sort of a convenient excuse. Maybe you aren't as thorough in your investigation about who's in the room when the strike hits because you want to take out important targets. I'm not saying that that happened, but I am saying we don't have enough information to know what the government knew when it ordered the strike.
But the only problem with that, Randy, is it implies bad faith. I don't know what the president knew, what he didn't know. I don't know what intelligence was there, what intelligence wasn't there, but
right.
I don't want to impart or imply bad faith. Apparently, the United States is attempting to protect us in the best way they possibly
can. And we have to go with what they tell us.
They engage in these strikes for purposes of protecting civilian lives in the United States and other places. And so in the event that they didn't know, I mean, who's to say that they are clear?
I do think, though, Joey, that the one thing that I think is very, very important, if you're going to take out an American citizen, if you're going to do a targeted assassination because he's an enemy of the United States, you better have that ordered directly by the President of the United States and not delegate it to some underling. Now, here, of course, they say this was accidental,
right.
So the President didn't directly order it. But if they know it's a hit on an American citizen, it better be the Commander-in-Chief making the
agreed,
decision.
Agreed, but that's not this case.
That is not this case.
That's
absolutely right.
Yep.
All right. Paul Callan, Joey Jackson, nice to see you guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.